Hello students, let us see the demo of program number 7, that is tetrahedron. Here is the program. Let me execute the program first. So it is asking number of subdivision. I am giving 0. So 0 is no subdivision. You will see the perfect tetrahedron. If you give number of subdivision is 1, so only 1 midpoints are calculated on each edges, so the remaining triangles are drawn. Now you have seen the output. Now we will see the program, how the program is running. Let me start from the main. So int main, argument c, argument v, these are command line arguments. Printf, we are asking number of divisions. So user will give 0, 1, 2, 3 depending on his interest. These are the basic commands of OpenGL, already I have explained. Let me give a brief explanation of this command. Glut init will initialize OpenGL with C++, that is argument C, argument V. Glut init display mode is initializing the display mode. So what are the initialization? Single means single buffering. The output is only one time it is coming. There is no animation. Front buffer, back buffer concept is not there. Then glut RGB. It is RGB color mode we are using. Depth. We are drawing a 3D image. So that the depth value is enabled here. Initialized here. Glut init window size. The initial window size output. The size of the output window is 500. Glut create window. So this will create a window with this title, tetrahedron. You can see the title. So here is the title bar, tetrahedron 3D gasket. So that output is coming here. Reshape function. So when you are resizing your output window, so I am resizing the output window according to the resize, the output should be adjusted. So that is explained in this function. We'll see later after seeing all this command. Then glut display function, display, we'll call the tetrahedron logic, shear spins key gasket. Then we are enabling GL depth test because we are using depth value. Glut main loop will keep your main under a loop. So return 0 because I am running this program in Windows. I have given return 0 and int main you can see. If you run in Ubuntu, you can use void main and there is no return command. Now in this, these are the two functions we have to see. First, we will see my reshape. We'll go to my reshape. This W and H will take your output window's width and height. GL clear color is clearing the background. Here, which is the background color? White. So the white color RGBA is given here. GL viewport is taking the current window's W value and H value. So that W value, H value from origin. Where is the origin? This is the origin. This bottom left corner. That is the origin. From origin, what is the W? H. That is taken. GL projection. GL matrix mode, GL projection. So this command is doing what? So GL projection is a matrix. A 4 cross 4 matrix which takes the output in a projection manner. This projector results. Like cinema projector, this output is projected using this GL projection matrix. GL load identity is a 1-1-1 matrix, unit matrix is multiplied. This is also a 4 cross 4 matrix multiplied with GL projection matrix. Why to multiply? It normalizes your output. Okay. Now this is the reshape option. If you are adjusting, whenever I do some adjustment, either W will get more or H will get more. So in this case, W is more. If I reduce like this, in this H is more, W is less. So according to the current WH, so any one of this condition will become true, either this or else condition. So we are giving both as minus 2 plus 2, minus 2 plus 2, minus 10 plus 10. Just we are resizing. We are converting back to the model view. Means the result is multiplied with GL model view matrix. We are using post redisplay. Now we'll go to the display function. We'll see the display function. We are clearing the color buffer and depth buffer. we are calling the tetrahedron function. N is number of subdivision. GL flush is giving you the output, flushing the output from your buffer, frame buffer. Now we'll go to the tetrahedron. You see the tetrahedron here. So int, let us take 0 first. 0 means no subdivision. So I showed the output of no subdivision. So tetrahedron is nothing but combination of 4 triangle, correct? So you know the triangle vertices already I have given. I'll explain once again. Here there are 4 vertices are there. I'll show you the output. So in this output, which are the 4 vertices? 0, 0, 1. So can you guess which is 0, 0, 1? That is the middle value, V0. So V1, V2, V3. Where is V1? Top is V1. This is V2, V3. So you have to imagine the GL ortho V volume. Minus 2, plus 2, minus 2, plus 2, minus 10, plus 10. In that V volume, these values are given and we have drawn a perfect tetrahedron. You can draw the tetrahedron with your value. You check using trial and error method. You imagine the point and give. So vertices are set here. Please remember these values are 3D. So x, y, z, 3 values are given for each vertex. So we were seeing this function. Tetrahedron is taking 4 triangles. These 4 triangles are drawn, correct? So this is red color. This is black color, this is green RGB blue color, and this is green color. So all 4 triangles are called. You know the vertex. Along with M value, we are passing the vertex. We'll go to the divide triangle now. Divide triangle will come here. We'll see the output. So in this divide triangle, if you pass this value, let us take the first value. This is which triangle? Red triangle, right? So let me take the left side, left red triangle. So V0 is top, middle, V1 is top, V2 is left. So these 3 values are passed, M. So the values are coming here. So when you pass this variable, these variables are reassigned to ABC. Now VF0 will become A, VF1 will become B, VF2 will become C. So M, same name we are using, M. Assume that we are passing the number of subdivision 1, m equal to 1. Here we are using a local variable v1, v2, v3, a local variable j. So first time condition is true or false. M equal to 1 means condition is true. 1 is greater than 0. So it comes inside. This for loop will run 3 times. Correct? I'll show you the output. This for loop will run 3 times. Why? Because each vertex is having 3 value. So if you want to find this midpoint, how many times you have to perform division? 3 times you have to do. And for the other one, now we have taken the example of red. How many midpoints are there? This is one midpoint, this is one midpoint, and this is another midpoint. So this is 3 times, and this is 3 times, and this is 3 times. Now we'll go to the function. So this will run 3 times. V1 is our local variable here. A and B is passed already. A and B is here. So A, B. This is my A, B, C. Assume. Okay, no need to assume. You can directly check. Which is A? V0 is A. You see here. V0, V1, V2. That is middle and top left. So this is A and this is B and this is C. Every time this A, B, C will keep on change. Because we are passing different vertices here. So this is A, B, C. A, B. Can you guess where is V1 here in this? V1 is this one. Because this is my A and this is B. A, C. A, B, C. So A, C is this edges. So A, C. This middle points are calculated and B, C. This midpoints are calculated. So now what has happened? Just we have calculated the midpoint. So after running this for loop, extra 3 midpoints are calculated. Still we have not drawn the triangle. So first divide triangle, it is recursively calling. So it is taking this value. So A is fixed. What is our A? So as per first assumption, A is here actually, middle. V1 and V2. Which is V1 and V2? By keeping A, where is V1, V2? Okay, M minus 1 will become 0. What is V1 and V2? Here we have calculated. V1 is nothing but AB by 2. That is this value. V2 is which value? AC. So AC. So this value. Correct. So point 1, this midpoint 2 and this midpoint 3, only these 3 points. So again you are passing that 3 points, m becomes 0, again you are going here. When m becomes 0, condition is true or false? Condition is false. You are coming to L's case. So first this triangle is drawn. This innermost right triangle will be drawn. After that, this 3 triangle condition will become 0 here. It will come, then that is drawn, here it is drawn. So as per this program, first right triangle 1, 2, 3, this is drawn. Then you come to this divide triangle, you call this function. This is which triangle? Black. In black, the top one and this left one, right one will be drawn. After that, RGB, blue triangle. In this blue triangle, I'll leave it to you. Out of this 3 triangle, which triangle will be drawn first? You can practice. By applying this vertices value over this divide triangle function, you check first triangle will be drawn where. Is it this one or this one or this one? So you'll get more practice and you can understand in depth. After drawing blue, we are passing the green. So all 4 divide triangle will be completed. You are coming out of this divide triangle. All these 4 divide triangle tetrahedron will come back to this line. Your output will be displayed here. This program you have to trace manually by passing all the value to each and every function. You can easily understand. I hope you have understood the tetrahedron function. We'll see next class. Thank you.